Dear students, once again with the same topic, probability. So basic, I have told you about probability, the formula for probability. Probability of any event A is number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. Like if you throw any coin, I have told you, you get a head or a tail. So if you want a head, then head is your favorable outcome, and total two outcomes are total number of outcomes. In case of dice, there are six outcomes, and if you want six, that means one is your favorable outcomes, and there are six numbers which are total number of outcomes. So there may be some conditions also. There may be two coins, there may be two dices also. So let us have some questions based on some basic concepts and based on two coins and three coins or two dices also. Now the first question I have written here is, in a single throw of a dice, find the probability of getting a number greater than 2. Now let us see, I will finish it in the given space just to explain. In a single throw of dice, if you have a dice, the total number of outcomes will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Total outcomes will be 6. Okay, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 2? Probability of any event E, I have told you, number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. So greater than 2, greater than 2 we have 3, 4, 5 and 6, 4 numbers. So total number of outcomes favorable are 4 and total number of outcomes are 6. So we can write 2 2s are 2 3s are. This is the answer of getting the probability, or the probability of getting a number greater than 2. Now the second question is, less than or equal to 2. Probability of getting a number less than or equal to 2. Now let us see, less than or equal to 2. Less than 2 we have 1, and equal to 2 we have 2. That means two numbers are your favorable outcomes. So two numbers and total number of outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 2 upon 6, that is 1 by 3 will be the probability of getting a number less than or equal to 2. Now the third part is, let us see third part, not greater than 2. Not greater than 2 means 2 se bada nahi hona chahiye. Now there is a condition also, whether the 2 is involved or not. In the first part, less than or equal to 2 was given. So not greater than 2 matlab 2 se bada nahi hona chahiye. Then you can have only 1, or in some conditions you can have 2 also involved in this. But for this condition, probability of getting a number not greater than 2, 2 se bada nahi hona chahiye means probability of getting a number not greater than 2 is equal to 1 upon 6. 2 is equal to 2, so 2 will not take, because in the first condition we have taken less than or equal to 2. So 1 upon 6 will be the probability of getting a number not greater than 2. Okay, this was all about the first question. Now let us see. Sorry for the less space, I have written 5 important questions, not to waste the time, that's why I have written already. Now, a letter is chosen from the word pencil. See, you have a word pencil. Question number 2. What is the probability that the letter chosen is a consonant? Now we all know, in A, B, C, D up to Z, we have consonants and what? Vowels. So we have, see, P, E, N, C, I, L. Total number of outcomes, you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. But consonants, vowels, you all know, A, E, I, O, U. Except A, E, I, O, U, all the words will be consonants. So in place of A, E, I, O, U, so E is here, I also is here. They are not of our work because they are vowels. So how many consonants are there? Total number of outcomes, and consonants. Consonants are 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 consonants are there. So, total 6 words are there and number of consonants are 4. So, probability of getting a number or a letter chosen is a consonants will be number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. So you have favorable outcomes 4 and total number of outcomes 6. So we'll write 2 upon 3. Okay. Third question we have is, in a single throw of die, find the probability of getting 8, a number greater than 8, a number less than 8. In case of a die, we all know outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Total number of outcomes, total outcomes are 6, but we have to find the probability of getting 8. Do we get any 8 there in the dice? No. So probability of getting 8 is 0 upon 6, that is 0. Probability of getting a number greater than 8. In any dice, we don't get a number greater than 8. So this also will be 0 upon 6, or you can say 0. First part, second part. And the third part is, a number less than 8. Probability of getting a number less than 8. So all the numbers are less than 8. So every time you will get a number less than 8. So 6 upon 6, that is probability is 1. 1 means 100% chances are there to get the probability of any number getting a number less than 8. Now, in question number 4, there are 2 coins. If you have 2 coins, see, in case of 2 coins, if 2 coins you are tossing, you will get head-head, or you will get head-tail, or you will get tail-head, or you will get tail-tail, nothing else. If you have 2 coins, you have 2 dice, the formula for getting total number of outcomes is total number of outcomes containing power, total number of coins or total number of dice. Like, if we have 2 coins, then total number of outcomes, formula is 2 power n, or you can say 2 power 2, because 2 coins are there. So 4 outcomes will be there, 1, 2, 3, 4. And those 4 outcomes will be head-head, head-tail, tail-head and tail-tail respectively. Now we have to get the probability of getting no tail. There is one condition when both the coins are giving head-head. So only one condition is there, so 1 upon total number of outcomes, 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1 upon 4 will be the probability of getting no tail. Now, probability of getting 2 tails. 2 tails also you are getting once. So 1 upon 4 will be the probability of getting 2 tails. Exactly 1 tail. Probability of getting exactly 1 tail. If it would have asked only 1 tail, then you can have counted this, this and this also. But only exactly 1 tail is asking for, so this is the condition and this is the condition. So we will write 2 upon 4, that is 50% chances are there. 1 by 2 means 50% chances are there to get exactly 1 tail. Let us see the last question. It's also very important. Now we have a dice. We have 2 dices. In case of 2 dice, total number of outcomes, the formula is 6 square, that is 36 outcomes will be there. What will be those 36 outcomes? Let us see. If 2 dice are there, 1 1 1 2 1 3 1 4 1 5 and 1 6, you will get 2 1 2 2 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5 and 2, 6. In the same way, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1 and 6, 1. 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2 and 6, 2. These are already the outcomes when you are tossing or throwing two dices. 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3 and 6, 3. Again, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6. 5, 4, 5, 5 and 5, 6. And the last line will be 6, 4, 6, 5 and 6, 6. All these you will get, only 36, not more than that, okay. Now, the question asking for, if you are throwing two dice, what is the probability of, let us see, two dice are thrown at the same time, find the probability that the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is zero. Probability of getting sum zero, will it be possible? At least one one will come. So, coming zero, the sum coming zero will never be possible. So first will be 0 upon 36 or you can say 0. Second part. Sum 12. Sum of two numbers, probability of getting sum 12. So let us see now. In what cases we are getting the sum 12? If in both the dices we are getting 6 and 6. So the sum will be 12, nothing else. See, 1 plus 1, 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 1 plus 3, 4. Are you getting 12 anywhere? No. Only one condition is there. So probability will be 1 upon 36. Third, less than 12, probability of getting the sum less than 12. This is an important part. Let us see. Except this, all the 35 times the sum is less than 12. So 35 upon 36 will be the probability getting the numbers less than 12. Okay. Less than or equal to 12 means every time. Less than or equal to 12. 36, all the 36 times will be, the sum will be less than 12. So 36 upon 36, that is probability will be 100% or 1. These were also some basic questions. Some more questions will be done afterwards. Thank you so much. See you soon.